Hey guys, in this video I'd like to talk about Cushing syndrome. So before understanding Cushing syndrome, we need to understand a lot about our adrenal gland. So for that we need to know what are the divisions of adrenal gland. Okay, apart from that, which part of adrenal gland produces what. So further we can start to understand the Cushing syndrome, right? So we'll start off with divisions of adrenal gland. Adrenal gland is divided into two regions. One is inner medulla and outer cortex. Adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. So we have two regions, cortex, and we have one more region, that is medulla. So first let's start off with what are the things which is produced by our adrenal cortex. So adrenal cortex has a multiple layers in it, that is three layers, that is glomerulosa, fasciculata reticularis, right? So we have three layers in the adrenal cortex. Each of them produces some particular hormones. Each layer produces some particular hormones. So zona glomerulosa produces our mineralocorticoids. Our fasciculata produces glucocorticoids. Our reticularis produces androgens, that is testosterone. So these are the three layers which is producing each of the following secretions, right? Now, so who is controlling these secretions? Who is controlling the secretions from the adrenal gland, right? So we need to understand for that pituitary. So pituitary is divided into two regions, anterior pituitary and posterior pituitary. Pituitary is further regulated from the hypothalamus. I'm not going into that physiology now. Now pituitary produces a hormone called ACTH. This ACTH will work on the adrenal gland. Now this adrenal gland will produce the glucocorticoids. So this is how it is regulated, right? Now adrenal gland is stimulated, what happened? Our glucocorticoids, that is cortisol, is produced, right? So this cortisol will have a negative feedback mechanism. What negative feedback mechanism is? It will go and give an inhibitory mechanism to the pituitary, means which will say pituitary to stop producing ACTH. If I increase more of cortisol in my bloodstream, what will happen? ACTH will be decreased. So this is the negative feedback mechanism. Right. So this is how secretions in the adrenal gland is regulated. This is the physiology of the adrenal gland. Now let's talk about adrenal medulla. Adrenal medulla produces something called catecholamines. Now Cushing syndrome is a disease associated with the glucocorticoids, so which is majorly associated with the cortex of the adrenal gland, which has nothing association with the medulla, which produces our catecholamines, right? Now let's start with Cushing syndrome. So any disease or syndrome, first we need to know the definition, right? So we have glucocorticoids, definitely we should have our glucocorticoid receptor. So any condition in which excessive stimulation of the glucocorticoid receptor, we are referring it to Cushing's syndrome. Right? We know the definition now. Let's start with etiology for Cushing's. So etiology for Cushing's, we can have more of ACTH, increased ACTH, right? That will lead to increased stimulation of the adrenal cortex, it will lead to increased production of the glucocorticoids. That is a one condition, let's see. Who is producing our ACTH? ACTH is produced by our pituitary. So if we have an adenoma in the pituitary, adenoma of the pituitary gland, pituitary adenoma. So in which there can be more level of ACTH, that more level of ACTH will stimulate the more formation of the glucocorticoids. This is one thing. We can have ectopic ACTH. So ectopic is nothing but which is not a regular site of production. Now regularly ACTH is produced from the pituitary. Instead of ACTH produced from the pituitary, it can be produced from the other locations. So it can be a ectopic ACTH. Ectopic ACTH is seen with the paraneoplastic syndromes. So it's very simple. In any abnormal neoplasms which is present in lung, for example small cell carcinoma of the lung, which might produce ectopic ACTH, that will lead to elevated ACTH, which will stimulate more of adrenal cortex and more of adrenal cortex hormones. So this is a etiology which is coming from the pituitary, right? Now we need to know something about ACTH which is coming from the pituitary adenoma. If more ACTH coming from the pituitary adenoma, more cortisol which is produced, we call it as Cushing's disease. Cushing's disease is associated with pituitary adenoma. Cushing's disease. Now, if you are confused with the etiology, it's very simple. These are the two conditions in which it is dependent on the ACTH. We can have other things which is not dependent on the ACTH. For example, there is a tumor or maybe some abnormal hyperplasia in the adrenal gland itself. That will lead to elevated production of the cortisol. That will have a different effect. So, that is ACTH independent, not depending on the ACTH. We have adrenal adenoma. And adrenal carcinoma. Right? So these are the conditions which might lead to Cushing syndrome. Now we know the etiology. How does patient come to us? What are the things we might find in the patient who is having a Cushing syndrome? Let's see the clinical features. So in both Cushing's disease syndrome, at the end of the day, what we have is elevated level of our cortisol. So if there is a cortisol elevated level, so what are the changes we can see in our body? Let's start with the clinical features, right? So clinical feature goes something like this. So more of, for example, more stimulation of the adrenal cortex will lead to more production of the cortisol, when there is an elevated cortisol, what will happen? Let's see. Now these people will come with moon-like face. Okay, they have central obesity. So why moon-like face and central obesity? It's very simple. Due to fat redistribution. Okay. So what else will happen in the patient? These people will have elevated level of blood glucose. Okay. These people will have high level of blood pressure. Increased blood pressure. And increased blood glucose. So why blood glucose will be increased? It's very simple. In the patients who is having Cushing syndrome, they have more of cortisol, there will be insulin resistance. Okay, so what else? Why BP will be elevated? Because in these people, more of sodium and water retention. Yes, it is similar action of mineralocorticoid. Also, remember something, glucocorticoids do have little bit action of mineralocorticoids in Cushing syndrome, more of glucocorticoids. So there will be elevated blood pressure. So what else we can find? These patients will have symptoms of peptic ulcer. peptic ulcer. Why these people can develop peptic ulcer? It's very simple. This peptic ulcer is produced as a result of phospholipase A2 inhibition. So about phospholipase A2 inhibition, there is a separate video about pharmacology of the glucocorticoids. There I have explained everything about phospholipase A2. You can go through that video also. Okay, now moon-like face, central obesity, elevated blood pressure, glucose is elevated, peptic ulcer. Is it the symptoms? No, we have further more symptoms. What else these patients will have? They will have something called purple striae. So it's very simple. The patient will have central obesity, right? Abdomen is being distended. So that time the patient will have this purple striae. Purple striae is something like a stretch marks on the abdomen. So that we are referring to purple striae. What else cutaneous manifestations we have? Let's see. So on the skin, we have one more thing, that is atrophy. Due to damage of striatum corneum layer of the skin, the patient will have a atrophy in the skin as well. Okay, these are the manifestation. We are not done with the manifestations yet. So let's see further other symptoms of the Cushing syndrome. Okay, now glucocorticoids are immunosuppressive. If they are immunosuppressive, the patient will have recurrent infections. Okay. What else the patient can have? So we know peptic ulcer, purple striae, atrophy, recurrent infections. Apart from these, the patient will have some symptoms which is associated, especially in the females, the patient will have some symptoms associated with the testosterone, that is elevated androgen levels. So because of elevated androgen levels, the women might have menstrual disturbances. Okay, what else will be there in women? There will be increased libido. Because of more testosterone, there will be elevated sexual drive in the female. Okay, the woman will develop a condition called hirsutism. So hirsutism is nothing but increased body hair. So that is generally more body hair is a feature of male. Because of elevated androgens, that is testosterone, the female might develop hirsutism. So these are the features of the Cushing syndrome. But we have left out with one last important symptom, that is osteoporosis. Why osteoporosis happens is, it's very simple. These glucocorticoids, whatever is produced, they activate osteoclast activation. Okay, so these are the symptoms of our Cushing syndrome. Okay, so you found a patient, you found the symptoms. Okay, now you are suspecting Cushing syndrome. But we need to have a proof. So we need to diagnose Cushing syndrome. So how do we diagnose the people who is having Cushing syndrome? Right? Let's discuss the diagnosis of the Cushing syndrome. Okay. Now, for diagnosis, we importantly use two tests. That is low dose dexamethasone suppression test. The second one is high dose dexamethasone suppression test. Okay, now what is the use of low dose? What is the use of high dose dexamethasone suppression test? First, let me tell you, dexamethasone is a corticosteroidal drug. It is a corticosteroidal drug. So when we put dexamethasone at low dose, what will happen? This dexamethasone will suppress the cortisol. Okay. Now what we will do? First, we will give low dose dexamethasone, then we check for the blood cortisol level. That should be suppressed because of the low dose dexamethasone. If that is not suppressed, it is saying the patient is having Cushing syndrome. So we just know Cushing syndrome. We need to know whether it is Cushing's disease, right? Whether it may be ectopic source of the ACTH, right? So for that purpose, we use high dose dexamethasone test. So in high dose dexamethasone test, what we do? We give a large dose of dexamethasone, okay? So, what is the use for the high-dose dexamethasone? To find the etiology. Okay, now how do we find the etiology? Let's take a patient who is having pituitary adenoma first. So, if the patient is having a pituitary adenoma, if I give a large doses of dexamethasone, what will happen? ACTH will be suppressed. In a large dose of dexamethasone, the ACTH will be suppressed. Now see, what can be the result? So, high dose dexamethasone, what we do is, if decreased ACTH, so the source is pituitary. Now we have second one, ectopic. If ACTH is not decreased, then it is ectopic. Now, we know ectopic or pituitary. If it is ectopic, we need to search for the other cause from where the ACTH is coming from. So, there may be carcinomas. More level of ACTH is a paraneoplastic syndrome to small cell carcinoma of the lung. Maybe think of small cell carcinoma of the lung, right? So, this is how we diagnose the patient who is having a Cushing syndrome. So these are the two important tests. Along with that, definitely important ones, we need to check for blood cortisol levels and we need to check for the blood ACTH levels. So once we are done with the diagnosis, we need to treat the patient. See, low dose dexamethasone test, I'm telling again, low dose dexamethasone test, dexamethasone suppression test is just used whether the patient is having Cushing syndrome or not. So once we are done with the low dose, then we go for the next test, that is high dose. Why? Because we need to find the etiological factor. That is the importance of low dose and high dose dexamethasone suppression test. Okay. Now, let's see the treatment. So, well, we found pituitary was the culprit. Maybe adrenal gland itself is the culprit. Now we need to see the treatment. Okay, so first thing, we need to start the patient with the drug called ketoconazole. So ketoconazole, it's an antifungal drug, still it has some effect in the patient who is having the Cushing syndrome. Okay, you put the patient on ketoconazole, but definitely it's not the mainstay of treatment. So we need to find the etiology. For example, it may be ectopic, so go and search for the tumor and resect the tumor. Okay. Now, if the patient is having pituitary adenoma, what do we do? It's very simple. Surgical resection. Of the tumor. Okay. The patient had, for example, adrenal tumor, maybe adrenal adenoma or carcinoma. Again, the treatment is very simple. We send the patient to surgical removal of the tumor. Sometimes what we do is one more thing, that is we remove the adrenal gland completely. The patient don't have a source for the glucocorticoids, then we put the patient on the corticosteroids. After surgical resection, maybe for example we remove the adrenal gland completely, then we go for replacement therapy with glucocorticoids. Else, important one, first start with ketoconazole, then go find the etiology. After we found the etiology, treat the etiology, with the surgical help. So this was about our Cushing syndrome, guys. Keep following. Thank you very much.